One thing I always wanted to do on my MacBook is play mobile games on it, and it was quite easy a few years ago when I just need to download a BlueStack to do so. But ever since Apple left Intel and went with its own chip, things are getting different. So to play mobile games on Mac, I will need a virtual device that let me run apps on it. And after searching, these three options came up. And of course, they won't work on Apple Silicon. So let's try out the first one, GeniMotions. GeniMotions is an Android emulator which mainly used by developer for testing, demo, and training. Basically, you'll need to create a virtual device by selecting from pre-built device or customizing from your own configuration. And I suggest you to do so unless you can play game with 2 gigs of storage. And there's no Play Store by default on this VM. We'll need to install a third-party app called OpenGApp to install. So after installing and playing some games on this VM, I'm pretty impressed by how well this Android emulator handles games. It's responsive, the speed and graphic are very close compared to the actual phone. But at the same time, I start notice some problem. This VM can only handle casual game like 2Ds or minimal 3D renderings due to the strict RAM and CPU settings. To solve this problem, there's no other choice but to increase the processors and memories. And currently, it is impossible to do so with the free plan. So are you willing to pay $49 or you just forget about GeniMotions and use Android Studio for completely free? If GeniMotion focuses more on testing, Android Studio is more about development, with the emulator being one part of it. From the device managers, you can create a virtual device for many different preset profiles. The best thing about Android Studio is you always get the latest Android versions. And most importantly, the freedom to upgrade the device storage, processor and RAM. So in the last step, when you create a new AVD, just click to show advanced settings to moderate the internal storage. You will see the memories and CPUs are unable to change in this dashboard, but I did figure out how to change that. So I will leave the tutorial in the video description. So just because it got the latest update, most of the app will be compatible and working pretty stable. Game are smooth, there's no problem with the connections, except for one thing, the in-game control. I find it's difficult to play game using the mouse to simulate dust gestures on the AVD screen. Is this possible to play? Yes. Is this bring the good gaming experience? I don't think so. So I think what we all need right now is an Android emulator that runs natively on Apple Silicon, easy to customize, and most importantly, easy to control. So that brings us to the last one, Moomoo Player Pro. Unlike Android Studio or GeniMotion, Moomoo Player Pro is built directly for gamer, not developer. If you take a closer look at the settings, everything here is straightforward for low-tech user for customize the AVD. Just option to options without any live code. The interface is super friendly, and the best thing, you can use a mouse and keyboard for in-game control. Even better is if you have a controller, because some of the game even support the haptic feedback that is just crazy for mobile games. So Moomoo Player, now they're offering 7-day trial, and after that you pay roughly $9 per month for the monthly membership. But don't worry, I got you covered, because I'm currently running the giveaway for monthly membership. So basically every month I'll give away 5 free membership. So how can you join? You just download Moomoo Player Pro, enjoy the free trial, and then comment on the comment section your email address used to create the account with Moomoo Player Pro. And after 2 weeks, I'll do the random pick on those contestants, and then I'll let you know the winners on my YouTube channels or on my Instagram. If you don't win this month, just keep going, because I do it every month. So maybe eventually you'll get like the free membership. So thank you guys for watching. I think now it's your turn to tell me what Android emulator that you like the best. Just tell me more in the comment section, and see you guys in the next video. Bye.